गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। नाउ स्टार्ट वी एक्सरसाइज नंबर 9, दैट मेथड ऑफ सीड प्रोडक्शन इन कोल क्रॉप। मेथड्स ऑफ सीड प्रोडक्शन इन कोल क्रॉप। इन कोल क्रॉप यू नो द कैबेज, कॉलीफ्लावर, दीज आर इम्पोर्टेंट टू क्रॉप इन ऑल। सो वी स्टार्ट द मेथड ऑफ सीड प्रोडक्शन। कैबेज। कैबेज रिक्वायर टू सीजन टू प्रोड्यूस सीड। कैबेज रिक्वायर टू सीजन टू प्रोड्यूस सीड। इन फर्स्ट सीजन The heads are produced and following second or next season the seeds are produced. In that, for production of seed they require two methods or two methods of seed production in cabbage crop. First is in situ method, second one is transplanting method. In situ method, for certified seed produce seed to seed, and in transplanting method the nucleus seed produce head to seed method. First we study the in situ method. In this method the crop is allowed to overwinter and produce seed in their original position where they are first planted. In situ means where we plant the first, our seeds are sown in that field. From that field the plant are grow and stand in same field up to the harvesting, and seeds are produced on a same field. Means it is a in situ method. And second one is a transplanting method. In this method, the mature plants are uprooted and the outer walls are removed. Then the plants are replanted in well prepared new field. In cabbage, during the seed production, three methods have been followed. We one by one explain. Then first, in transplanting method, the whole plants, mature plants are uprooted. Transplanting means the crop are produced in one field and they are transplanted into the next or other field. This is called as transplanting method. In cabbage, the three important methods of transplanting. First, that is stem method. I explain one by one. First is a stump method. The name itself, that is stump method. When the crop in the first season is fully mature, the heads are examined for true to type. The plants with off types heads are removed. Means in stump method, the heads are examined for true type. If any disadvantage or dissimilarity occur in their physical nature of plant or genetically, they are removed. The plants with off types heads are removed. Means then the heads are cut just below the base by means of a sharp knife. Means the heads is cut just below the base with a sharp knife, keeping the stem with outer overs of leaves intact. The beheader portion of plant is called as stumps. Means heads are removed, only the base portion is kept with their small with few leaves. This is called as stumps. Means the beheaded portion of plant is called as stump. The stump are either left in situ or replanted in a second season in a new field after overwintering or after breaking the dormancy of the seed, they are or dormancy of the crop, they are transplanted into the next field. The buds sprout from the axis of the all leaves and leaves cardias. These are the stem method in which only stem portion, that is beheader portion or base portion, are kept in a field. All other portion are removed. This is called as stump method. Then some advantages of the stump method here. The stump method give extra income by way of sell the head. Means by after cutting the heads, the farmers are sell in a market and give extra income. That is first advantage of the stump method. Second one is crop mature within 12 to 15 days earlier as compared to other methods. The seed yield is slightly high. some disadvantages. Flower stars are decumbered and require very heavy sticking. Means we remove the head portion of the crop. That reason we require staking at the time of emergence of flowering to prevent from the lopping or slanting of the plants or inflorescences. Then second method is stem with central core intact method. In that method, when the crops is fully matured in first season, off type plants are removed and rejected. Then the heads are chopped on all sides with downward perpendicular cuts in such a way that the central core is not damaged. Without damaging the central core, the heads are chopped downward perpendicular. Okay, then when the heads start bursting after overwintering, when at the time of flower emergence from the head, the two vertical cross cut are given to the head. After just start emergence of flowering, taking care that the central core, central growing point or central core is not injured or not damaged. Without damaging the central portion of the head, we take two vertical cut just after the emergence of the flower. In the absence of such cut, the heads brush out irregularly and sometimes the growing tip is broken. Means if we do not take two cuts vertically, the head after emergency, the head brush or emergency of the influence, the irregularity of influences. Means they do not produce or they produce one side of flowering, other sides are off type or not growing the flower. That reason we give the two perpendicular cut, and sometimes the growing tips or the growing tips is also broken. That reason we take two cuts, vertical cuts at the time of just emergence of flower. This is the stem with central core intact method. Some advantage of this method is, first, shoot arising from main stem are not decumbered, hence very heavy staking is not required. Means in that method we the heads remain as it is, only chop the head. That reason we do not require the heavy staking. Then yield is high. By this method, yield is high. Some disadvantages: the chopped head cannot be marketed at the time of stem and central core intact method. In that method, we head is chopped all side. That reason it is not recommended for the market, or not edible portion as remain in a field. That reason it will not sell in a market. These are the disadvantage of the stem with central core intact method. Now third method is a head intact method. In this method, when the crop is fully mature in first season, the head are examined for two types. The plants with off types heads are removed from the field and rejected. The head is kept intact. Only a cross cut is given to facilitate the emergence of stalk. Here we take only cross cut is given. In previous method, stem with central core intact method, which whole head is chopped, their labor is more required as compared to the head method. Here we head intact method, only cross cut is given. Okay, the advantage of the head intact method is save time and labor, because only cross cut is given. That reason we save time and labor. Here very heavy staking is not required due to presence of head. Here staking is not required. Disadvantage is seed yield is slightly low as compared to the other method, because the head is growing and influence is also growing. That is a nutrition is split towards heads and also influences. That reason seed yield is slightly low as compared to the previous two methods. Then next important point is a seed stages of seed production. First, widow seed stage, then foundation seed stage, and second, last is a certified seed stage. These are the stages of seed production: widow, foundation, and certified seed. Some important varieties of cabbage here, according to their maturity. First, early variety of cabbage, that is golden acre, usa mukta, chowbhatiya early. Then mill cultivars or mill variety of cabbage, pride of India, usa drumhead, aru glory, and green express. Late cultivars or late variety of cabbage, large late drumhead, September, green challenger, bss 50, bss 32, bss 44, bss 115, and green ganesh, Sri Ganesh Goat. These are the late cultivars of cabbage. And one that is red acre is a red color cabbage variety. Okay, red acre is a red color cabbage variety. The next important point is a season. This season and the land requirement and the other cultural operation we study in a previous semester, that is temperate, in a temperate vegetable crop. That reason we not go detail in that point, that is land requirement. We prepare the field, or in that field any cold crops, or in previous 2 years no grow any cold crops because they increase the impurity or they increase the pest and this attack in the field. That reason we go fresh field for the growing of cold crop seed production, not any previous cold crop growing the same field previously up to 2 years. Then isolation requirements, it is a main important point for seed production. We know isolation means keep the field or keep the main plot of seed production from other plots of same variety or other cultivars to maintain the genetic and physical purity of crop and give quality seed. So you see here, the seed field must be separated from field of other variety at least now where the cabbage crop is studied, the isolation distance vary according to the crop to crop. Cross-pollinated crop require more isolation distance as compared to self-pollinated crop, and foundation seed is require more isolation distance as compared to the certified seed. So here, cold crop cabbage, in cabbage isolation distance required for foundation seed is 1600 meter for foundation seed and 1000 meter for certified seed. Okay, then seed rate for early varieties 600 gram per hectare and for late varieties 400 gram per hectare. Then seeds are treated with some fungicides to prevent the seed borne diseases. Okay, like Captan, okay, etc. They prevent the seed borne diseases. The nursery, we already know the nursery about the cabbage nursery, then transplanting also, then main field preparation. In the main field preparation, we add FIM at a proper, that will decompose FIM 50 to 60 tons FIM per hectare. And transplanting, the main important point is that is spacing according to the cultivars. For late variety, that is 60 by 60 centimeter. For medium variety, 60 by 40 centimeter. And for early variety, 45 by 45 centimeter. Deep spacing is recommended for cabbage crop for seed production, that is early 45 by 45 centimeter, then mid late, that is 60 by 40 centimeter, and for late cultivar, that is 60 by 60 centimeter. In that spacing, we transplant the cabbage crop in a main field.